What's going on, peeps? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm actually going to be talking about shooting 6x6 format. And I'm actually going to give you six of my own tips on how to compose images when dealing with a square crop. So I should probably start off by saying that not all of those images in that little intro were my own. For the sake of this video, I actually reached out to a few photographers that I follow on Instagram who shoot a lot of 6x6 work and whose work I enjoy seeing on my feed. And yeah, I just basically sent them a message and said, look, I'm working on this video on how to compose when shooting 6x6 format. Would you be interested in letting me kind of showcase some of your work and giving you a shout out? Of course, most of them said yes. But then I tried to push it a little bit further and said, you know, I'm going to be giving my own tips on how to compose 6x6. Do you have anything you could add or any tips that you suggest to people that are either trying to get into square format or just get better at it? And yeah, luckily the majority of them all got back to me. So how I'm going to start this video is I'm just going to show you a few of each of these photographers' photos. They've all got varying levels of, you know, followers on Instagram, up to like, I think like 35,000 down to less than 1,000. So they're definitely at different levels of people that follow them, but that doesn't mean they're at different levels of their skill of photography. Like, I enjoy seeing all of their work on my feed, so I thought I'd showcase all of them. So yeah, I'm just going to show you a few of their photos first, give you their names so you can follow them yourself, and give you their tips as well on composing 6x6. And then what I'll do after that is we'll come back and I will give you my six tips for composing 6x6. So first up is Mark Forbes. Now Mark is a film photographer based in Australia. He shoots a lot of really interesting 6x6 work. He's one of these photographers that's really good at kind of finding like beauty in the mundane and, you know, finding interesting shots just kind of based around everyday life and stuff like that. Things that other people might miss. I really enjoy his feed, I really enjoy seeing his posts every time he posts something new, and it's definitely a style of photography that I aspire to get better at myself. I think Mark's got around 33,000 followers on Instagram, and you know, a quick flick through his feed and you can kind of see why he's at that level, because he's got a really great eye for photography and light and just making interesting things out of something that others may not see themselves. So the tip that Mark gave me for composing 6x6 is this. My tip for 6x6 is to try and focus on a clean, uncluttered frame and avoid the tendency to put the object in the center of the frame. Now, I'm not going to break that down into too much detail, because when I give my tips, I'm going to go into them in a bit more detail, and that's kind of similar to something that I'm going to say. But the one thing that I did take away from that is to avoid the tendency to put the object in the center of the frame. Now, I think personally, I do this a lot of the time when shooting a square, because it's such a simple shape and you don't have much wiggle room. You kind of do have a tendency to put your subject slap bang in the middle, and I think looking through his work, you know, you can see that you don't have to do that, and actually it makes it much more interesting when you don't just slap your subject or whatever you're taking a picture of slap bang in the middle. So next up, we've got a guy named Ovi, and his Instagram handle is Focusing Film. We've followed each other for a few months now. I can't remember who followed who first, but I shoot with a Mamiya C330 for my square format, and he shoots with a Mamiya C220, I think, which is just, they're very similar models. And yeah, I just love his work. I love his landscapes and his portraits and everything he does with square format. I think he's only got less than 1,000 followers on Instagram, and his work is really, really good. So definitely check him out if you're into 6x6 format and give him a follow. So the tip that Ovi gave me for composing 6x6 is this. I believe that most rules in photography are flexible and can be broken. I'd like to say that there is a lot of thought process that goes into my compositions, but there isn't. My tip is around not what is in your composition, but rather what shouldn't be. Now, I think that last sentence is a really interesting point. A lot of the time when you're composing an image and seeing what's going on in it, you're focusing on a lot of the elements that are there, and you want to make sure that element is there. And you don't necessarily take time to think about what shouldn't be there until afterwards, when you get the photo, you know, into Lightroom and you're editing it or post-processing the images. So it's definitely important to take that time to slow down when you're taking a photo and just look what is in the frame and what you don't want to be in the frame. So next up is a photographer named Daniel Regner. And I hope I'm saying that right. Apologies if I'm not Daniel. He is a cinematographer and a photographer based in Baltimore in the USA. His 6x6 work is kind of a little bit of everything, but you can tell that he takes a lot of influence from cinema and movies just from looking at his style and the way he composes images. So Daniel's tip for composing 6x6 is this. I would suggest a tip for composing to be, if you're shooting a subject and you are in need of more depth or foreground, bring the camera to the ground, as it will fill the frame with a gradient of foreground focus and offer a more unique perspective than you typically get while standing normally. And I 100% agree with this. Whenever I find myself shooting with a TLR, especially if I'm shooting landscapes or stuff like that, I often find myself getting really low to the ground and just kind of filling the frame, like almost half of my frame, if not more, with foreground. I think it's important, well, I'm going to talk about this when I give you my tips, but when you're shooting square, it's much more important to kind of build layers in terms of three-dimensional layers, rather than going from left to right, going from back, front to back. So next up is another photographer based in the USA who goes by the name of Corey Marr. And you can find him on Instagram as The Real Corey Marr. Now Corey is based in Colorado in the USA and he shoots predominantly just these beautiful landscapes on 6x6 film. And he does a great job at using layers like I just mentioned within his photos. So having an element of foreground, midground, background and stuff to build up the layers within these photos to just make them really beautiful and really interesting to look at. Corey's tip for shooting 6x6 is remember the basics. Leading lines and rules of thirds are my go-tos whenever I'm out shooting. Since you're limited on the horizontal axis, you really have to focus on your composition within the square frame. But I think if it's done well, the square can easily make an image where sometimes the rectangle ratio cannot. Now I really agree with that statement of Corey's. Like a lot of the time I think people think that shooting square is limiting in an element and you know you could just shoot 6x7 or shoot wider and crop it in. But I think when you go out with the intention of shooting a square frame, you really think about things differently and you can often get an image that you wouldn't have got were you shooting with a wider field of view. So last up is another photographer based in Australia whose name is Liam Cartledge and you can find him on Instagram as Liam Photo. Liam is another one of these photographers like Mark Forbes that does a really, really good job of finding like beauty in the mundane. When you scroll through his feed, just like I love seeing like all of his work, but his 6x6 work in particular is just on point. So Liam's tip for composing 6x6 is, my tip for composing with 6x6 is don't go out looking for scenes to compose in square format so much. Rather just look for any scene that resonates with yourself and then look at it through the viewfinder or ground glass. The majority of the time for myself, there's a certain element you exclude or include by getting further or closer and shifting left to right, working the scene, as some may say. The best part of 6x6 is if you come across something perfectly symmetrical or in total isolation, balancing the frame is so much easier and it works so well in square format. I think that was a great tip. I honestly completely agree with everything that Liam said there. I think the best way to get used to composing 6x6, if you're not, is to actually have a camera like a TLR or a Hasselblad or a Rolleiflex, something that where you've got that ground glass and you can view and you get used to viewing the world in square format and just take it out and go and shoot and just get used to kind of working the scene and finding what works out best, you know. It's the same with any kind of photography really, just practice makes perfect. So thanks guys, really appreciate all your tips and all of you letting me share your work and stuff. All of these guys, I've put their Instagram handles in the description. Please go check them out, give them a follow if you're into kind of 6x6 or just film photography in general. For now, let's get into my 6 tips for composing 6x6. So my first tip for composing 6x6 is kiss. And by KISS, I mean the abbreviation Keep It Simple Stupid. Now, I don't know who actually come up with that abbreviation, but it makes a good point. A square is a perfectly balanced, perfectly symmetrical shape. And actually, when viewing it, rather than your eyes darting, you know, left to right and up to down, like they would with a normal sort of rectangular image, they're kind of more forced to either A, view the image as a whole, or B, view it around in a circle. Because of this, you really want to avoid overcomplicating your image, and you really want to try and keep it uncluttered and to the point. Now, one of the photographers that actually made me initially fall in love with 6x6 square format was Vivian Meyer. I stumbled across her work, and then I ended up watching a documentary about her, and her work is just amazing. If you're not aware, she was a street photographer, she was a nanny, and when she was like looking after the kids walking the streets or just in her spare time, she'd shoot a lot of photography and document the streets with her. I think she had a Rolleiflex, she had a Mamiya C330, my camera at one point as well. And I think one of the reasons why her images have such an impact is just because of their simplicity. She keeps them simple, she keeps them to the point, and I think the square format really adds to that as well. So yeah, just basically keep it simple, stupid. Now, my second tip for composing 6x6 is layers and filling the frame. When you're shooting with a normal aspect ratio, it's very easy to have something going on, you know, like the left side and something going on the right side, and having different elements happening within the image. When you're shooting with a square, it's a lot tighter, and actually adding sort of different elements to it is a lot harder. It's usually best to, instead of thinking of it in a 2D way of having something here and something here, you have to kind of go out of the box and think more three-dimensional. So, like we've mentioned before, having something going on in the foreground, something going on in the midground, and something going on in the background, and adding as much layers and stuff to your image as possible is really going to help create a better image when shooting 6x6. Tip number three is to focus on shapes. Now again, because you're shooting square format and the actual image itself is going to be a square, I think that kind of adds to this whole geometrical vibe of shooting, and adding a shape within a shape is going to give it a much more interesting feel. So, you know, if you're shooting something that is a circle or a triangle, or trying to add a sort of shape within a shape is going to give you like a frame within a frame, and it really adds to the image by doing it that way. Tip number four is to make use of negative space. Now, this can be said for any aspect ratio, to be honest with you, but I think it's made much more prominent when you're shooting 6x6, and it's much more easier to isolate a subject and fill the frame with a lot more negative space than usual. Tip number five is to make use of symmetry. Now, this is similar to tip number two, making use of shapes, in the fact that a square is a very mathematical shape. You know, it's perfectly symmetrical. There's something about it that lends itself to using other mathematical things like shapes or symmetry. Being able to split an image either horizontally or vertically or diagonally, and having one side of the image mirror the other, works a lot better when you're shooting with a square. Last but not least is tip number six. Take advantage of the rule of thirds. Now, the rule of thirds is a great way to compose your image with whatever aspect ratio you're shooting. But when you're shooting a square format, it really does help to compose with that image. Whether you're going to place something, you know, on this side of the frame or this side or central, or placing your eyes so they're on the top line of the frame, however you're using the rule of thirds, it really lends itself to the square format in a way that's really going to help you. And whether you're using that sort of after you've taken the photo to kind of crop it in and fix things a little bit, having that overlay of the rule of thirds on your images to be able to place things where you want them within them is really, really, really helpful. So that was my six tips for composing the 6x6 format. If you've made it this far, I really do appreciate you taking the time to watch my video. If you're new to my channel, I've got plenty of other videos like that in the backlog, so feel free to have a peruse from my old videos and maybe click subscribe if you're interested. If you're a regular viewer of my channel, just a quick update on what's coming from me. So basically, I've got maybe one or two new videos to release before Christmas, and then after that I'm going to take a couple of weeks break, and then I'll be coming back with not one but two new series. So basically, I'm still going to keep doing what I have been doing, where, you know, I'm kind of testing out various cameras, whether they be film or digital, and just kind of trying to make entertaining videos and showing you sample photos of what I was able to get. But I'm also going to be starting these two new series. So one is based around a photography project that I've just started of my hometown, and it's a year-long photography project where I'm going to be documenting my hometown throughout the winter months and the summer months. And then at the end of the year, I'm going to try and release a book or a zine based around all the collection of photos I've managed to get. So I thought basically I'd do a series of videos, you know, just kind of bringing you along the way of the journey, kind of whether I'm going out shooting, updating you on the photos I've got. You know, I'm going to be approaching strangers for portraits and stuff, so maybe I'll do some videos based around that. And then at the end of the year, I'm going to obviously make a book or a zine, so I'll do some videos based around how I'm making it, how I'm publishing it and stuff like that, just to kind of bring you along the journey. So that's going to be called the Southend Project, based around my hometown, Southend-on-Sea. And then my other series is going to be called Photo Walk and Talk. So, you know, basically I love photography, I find it very therapeutic, and I love talking about photography, but in case you hadn't noticed, I love talking just in general. So I kind of wanted to do something where, you know, it could still be photography related, but I could talk about perhaps things that are going on in my life at the time, things that are happening in the world, just things I'm interested in, and potentially maybe, you know, once COVID has calmed down a little bit, take other photographers and people on for photo walks and kind of talk to them and interview them maybe at the same time while we're going for a photo walk. So yeah, I'm interested to get my teeth stuck into that and see where that progresses. So they're both coming from me in the new year, two new series, as well as what I've already been doing, and yeah, hopefully it goes all right. But once again, appreciate you taking the time to watch my video, appreciate all the people that subscribe to my channel, and hopefully catch up with you guys soon.